Do this. What is happening, guys? Welcome to Game Week 27 Review, the Tuesday after, usually the Monday, but Monday was my birthday, so I didn't stream. But we're back again on Tuesday. James is still on holiday, so instead of James for the usual Monday sesh, we've got FF Community. Holly, what's going on? Hello!
Hi, Dave. Thanks for having me. I hope you had a good birthday, by the way, and I thought I'd come on straight after your birthday so that you didn't have too much time to dig up some dirt on me, because I've seen what these streams could be like in the past. And no. I also thought, get myself in on the early week stream, the main one week.
And then that means that we can talk about all the juicy stuff and have the juicy questions and all that.
Exactly.
That's a good idea. Well, thank you very much for coming on. Thank you very much for coming on so quickly that I couldn't look at all the skeletons in your closet. That's good. usually when we have big guests like yourself, we do the FPL and chill, but there's too much stuff to talk about. And also, you're kind of a regular chatter in the old stream here, and we do a podcast every Monday. So I feel like that we could save that to go through at a different time where I've got enough time to, you know, check all the people that you've slagged like secretly or something, or all the websites that you tried to build back in the day and didn't work out. I love all that stuff. Well, we'll do that later.
Yeah,
I've got your Twitter in front of us, so just really quickly, how did you do this week, and what are you working on?
Well, it was a disaster to start off with on Saturday. I had 12 points from 6 players, and I wanted to hibernate and hope that we could just start game week 28 already. And then somehow all of the last 5 players that I had in the game week all delivered points, and I ended up on 61 points and a 60k green arrow. So I'm absolutely delighted with that, because it was looking really grim at one point.
That's really, really good. I've revealed the 61 points in the stream. You got Sace, or Sass, or how you say his name, Mr. Sassy from Wolves in. Who did the business for you? Calvert-Lewin continues. Mane is now the differential. Are you worried that you're now going to have a captaincy problem with those two? Because honestly, I did think you captained Mane, and then you didn't. But it's only 1 point. But like, it's gonna happen. You're gonna have to figure it out.
Yeah. Well, to be honest, like you just said, it is a differential having Salah and Mane at the moment. So I feel like I don't need to even consider Mane in the captaincy discussion when Salah's chipping away, because
true,
if Salah bangs, everyone's got Salah, most people have captained, and I'm with them, and I've got Mane on the side as well, so when he gets goals as well, I'm still going up. That's the logic at the moment. But you know, I think with Mane at the moment, he's still coming back from an injury layoff, isn't he? And I just think Salah's a bit more consistent for now, but that could change in a couple of weeks. But yeah, differential. So
I like that.
Doing all right.
I like that answer. Well, it's an amazing game week for you. It's really nice to know that I would have beat you had that Aguero goal went in. That just makes me feel so much better as well. Honestly, because he would have been the only goal potentially. Maybe 3 bonus points, maybe 2. It would have taken my tally up to a grand total of 63. But not to be, not to be. thank you everyone who's in the live chat. If you're here for the first time, it'd be awesome if you followed, because then I'll get to 300 followers. And once that happens, I'm going to do a super awesome special stream. I don't really know what that is yet, but I know it's going to be good, because I'll probably pay a circus to come on or something. I don't know, we'll figure it out, but it's gonna be amazing. So yeah, but yeah, thank you very much for coming on. We've got the usual people. Dafts is here, go mental in the chat, how's it going? Liam's here, it's raw. Our man Tom from China, or China Tom as my girlfriend calls him, sent me a fiver on PayPal through the stream yesterday, even though I wasn't streaming, for my birthday, which was really nice. Didn't have to do that.
Show me
no
up
one,
here.
No one had to do that. It was just really, he makes a packet in China. Trust me, he's fine. And also, someone else sent me this, which is a mouse mat with De La Feu's face on it. Lovely. And that was from Andy. Thank you very much, Andy. Holly, I don't know if you're aware, but I absolutely fucking hate De La Feu. and that stems from back in the day when, just before the season started, everyone had him in their teams. Do you remember Watford had a pretty decent run? And so there was a few people putting De La Feu in their rate my team, sending it to me. And it was the most annoying thing in the world. I had to like I had to channel everything I had to not scream at people, because he was a midfielder last year and then now he's not, and it was like, there's no point. There's absolutely, I was infuriated because it just happened so much. And then now anytime he does that one assist that he gets every five games, I get so many people tweeting me and be like, ah, Delphi. And so now I get to look at his face anytime I need to use my mouse, which is amazing.
So Delphi is like the running joke of the stream.
Yeah, unfortunately for me, because
like your favorite player.
Yeah, exactly. Not. And like yours is Milner, right? So that's kind of the same thing-ish a little bit.
Oh, we're not bringing up Milner tonight, are we?
No, we are not. So what I thought of to start with, there's my team in front, if anyone was worried that I deleted it or something. You got a really big rise in overall rank as well. I was excited about my 50k, but you're on 238,000. Yeah, that's so good. 007. Nice. I love it. You're never going to forget it.
I did it on purpose because I knew I was coming onto the stream.
I like that a lot. I feel like somehow we could make your kit like a 007 kit as well. You guys can't see it, but like it's plain. I never use my kit either. But you could like make it into like black with maybe like, you know, that fake suit thing on. I don't know if they do that. They don't really have that many accessories in there. So today we got the tweet up. Today we're going to do standout teams, like what's actually happening between now and, you know, I don't know, six game weeks, eight game weeks ahead, what the standout teams are from game week 27, what we can expect going forward, all that good stuff. Final blank 28 thoughts, because unfortunately it's fucking here and we've got to talk about it again. are you getting as annoyed talking about the blanks as I am? Like that every punter is.
I love the blanks because people go to set up their team and they're like, oh no, I've only got like three players playing and I've just, you know, planned carefully and then they get no points anyway.
All right. So you like it from like a competitive point of view?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. You're like, yes, more shite players for me to beat every blank. Chain Fire in the chat says, not FPL related, but Holly, have you ever been to Beverly? I don't know what that means.
And I said, I used to live in Beverly.
Oh, did you really?
For 5 years, 4.5 years.
Wow, that's so
before
weird.
I decided that I couldn't stay away from Grimsby any longer because, you know, obviously it's the best place in the world. So I came back to Grimsby.
It's such a strange thing that someone would ask that, though, in the chat. Like, I like
all,
that.
All
it's like
fans.
Your stalker's in there. Chainfire, it's great to have
I'm assuming that Chainfire is
your husband
from Beverly,
yeah.
Which is why
fair enough. Let me see who else said something there. Oh yeah, Daff said my mate brought in Auba and Saka. That's like the best and also the worst. Like he's picked Arsenal because they've done well and then now they're blanking. That must feel satisfying if you're in a mini league with someone who's that bad at this game. It's not bad, but it's
I
just
like Arsenal though. Like,
yeah,
I think there'll be a decent team to invest in once we get this blank out of the way. I wouldn't be selling any Arsenal players because they've got a blank this week. Because
right.
I think Arteta's starting to have a bit more of an influence over how they're doing.
Fair enough. So that brings, you have just swiftly moved on to our first topic, Flick. Which is lovely. Arsenal have the fourth best fixtures for the next six games. It's in front of us here. West Ham, Brighton, Southampton, Norwich. Bamian has scored 3 goals in 3 games. I know him because I've had him for 3 games. Thank you very much. I won't talk about Aguero. And Saka has had, I think, 3 assists or something in 4 games, which is more than any other midfielder. And they kept clean sheets, which I don't understand. But they shouldn't be able to do that with the players they've got. But alas, they fucking done it, didn't they? What do you think of so you've just said there, like people should keep them for the blanks. Is that like if you had Auba, you would just leave him in your team?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, they've scored 9 goals in the last 4 games, mm-hmm. and a couple of clean sheets in there, as you've mentioned. I think there are options from this team. I think you've got to consider holding them.
Would you bring them in?
Well, obviously not this week because I've got a blank. But 29, yeah.
Right, okay. So from 39 onwards.
Yeah, so like West Ham, Brighton, Southampton, Norwich.
Yeah,
The
and then if
next
that doesn't
four,
work
double
out,
rank.
if that doesn't work out, you can always bring in like a Wolves player or whoever's banging elsewhere. The best thing about having
Yeah,
Aubameyang
exactly.
is like he's like the most expensive striker, one of, so it's really easy to go down from there.
Yeah. I was surprised to read, and I think this is probably just an oversight on my part, that he's in the lead in the Golden Boot race. Is it
Was he
17
really?
goals?
How many does Ings have? Surely he can't be far away.
15? I think Ings is on 15.
15.
Let's have a
Okay,
look.
cool.
Yeah.
That's so close. He could just bang a hat trick in next game and then he's like top. How mental is that? You're a hat trick away from the golden boot. I like that.
Oh, it's wide open. You've got Aubameyang, Vardy on 17, Aguero on 16, and then Ings and Salah on 15.
How mental is that like you buy Aubameyang and you buy Aguero, and if I told you right there and then game week 25, only one of them is going to score in the next three games and it's going to be three goals. Who would you pick for that? You'd pick
I
Aguero, right? You'd be like, okay, it's
know.
Aguero,
Yeah,
Aubameyang's going to
absolutely.
blank. But it's the other way around, which is hilarious. So what do you think the winning formula, like what's going on? Arteta's just a good manager? That can't be right?
Well,
Put words in your
he's had
mouth.
to, he spent a lot of time with Pep, hasn't he?
Yeah.
So hopefully that's transcending through, you'd think. And you know, he's a legend of Arsenal as well. So
Yeah, that's true.
hopefully those two things combined are bringing
Like the
the winners in the right
transformer of
direction.
Arsenal, right? That's Arteta. It's a turn in fixtures.
Yeah.
Bellerin's back. He's brought in Ozil again, who's I don't really know. Like, obviously, we could talk about Arsenal. We want Aubameyang. We wish Saka was a defender. But are you going anywhere near their midfield? Pepe, Ozil, Saka, I guess 4.5 million.
I really dislike Pepe, but
Yeah.
he's doing all right, to be fair to him. But 9.2 million, and you know, some days you could give him 10 shots and he'd miss everyone. So
Yeah. Sounds
you
like
never know what you're
De
going to
La
get with
Feu. Yeah, fair
Pepe. Day
enough.
starts, you'll get a Pepe mouse mat
I would like
next
that.
birthday, or
If
a
people to keep
mug with
sending me
Pepe's
them, and
face on.
I could give them away as like prizes. Like second
The prize that no one wants to win.
Exactly. Daft says he's captaining Vardy next week and bringing Ozil in. It's Ross says that Arteta's a wizard, and Lassihar says I'm selling Aubameyang for DCL after the West Ham game. So after West Ham, so you're keeping them for the blank, and then you're selling after West Ham for DCL, who has Liverpool. That is interesting. It's very interesting. I don't understand why you would do that. Or do you mean
He
after
obviously
the.
saw that Liverpool conceded two goals last night.
There you go. Should we talk about that? What do you think of that? West Ham scoring two goals. That shouldn't
It was an
happen.
interesting game, wasn't it? I think all the anti-Liverpool people were hoping that it was a Gerrard-esque slip that was gonna
Oh my God.
make their season just crumble in front of the eyes. But you know what Klopp can do
That would be
on the
amazing if that
field.
happened and then City start banging. So from an FPL point of view, that would actually be better, right? Because that means that Liverpool would still have to keep trying in the league, so we wouldn't have to worry about their assets in our team. City would then start trying a bit more, so we could bring them in a little bit more, and it'd be a bit more like
Yeah.
last season. But now we've got to like, are they going to play? Do you
Yeah,
think they're
but
going to play them?
they've still got the Invincibles thing, haven't they, to go at, and I think that's pretty important for them. They're on for a record-breaking season. You've got to bear in mind that I think I saw a stat that no club had got this many points at this stage in the season across Europe's
Yeah.
top five leagues, like
Ever, right?
ever.
That's
So
mental. So you think he
they,
cares about, do you think Klopp cares? Has he came out and said that he cared, yeah?
I don't know if I've read anything, but I think like it's all in hand, isn't it? And I think the Champions League, they can do well in that as well, and the two things can go hand in hand. It doesn't need to be one or the other for them.
Right.
I think with the fact that the league is pretty much wrapped up already, they can play a bit more with confidence.
Yeah, no, I absolutely agree. Like they'll just be like, "Oh, we've won. We might as well just have fun." And then that's when Salah shoots 40 times in one game and gets 9 goals. Like everyone's gonna be like, "Oh, we'll just play it on top of them. We'll try and play how Norwich plays, but just everyone will play that against Liverpool now, and that will be great.
Yeah.
And then I'll bring in Mane and Firmino, and I'll do a Ben Dinnery.
Salah, Mane, Firmino.
It's mental. It's just ridiculous. I can't believe he's on the pod. Oh my God. Jimmy's here. Dave is what he said. Thanks very much for being here, Jimmy. Jimmy. Daff says, serious question. Do you think that Liverpool will start playing the kids, or does Klopp go and plough on? Because I don't think that the foreign managers takes much care of records. We just said that obviously we do think he probably will have a, like, because this is a good record. It's not like a shit one. This is like the invincible season, right? But do you think he's going to play his kids in the FA Cup?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, I think the fact that it's Chelsea away, he is going to have some experience in there. But, I mean, the treble's on, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, see, that's another thing we've got to think about.
And they've won the Club World Cup as well, so it's
a quadruple year.
Effectively a quadruple, isn't it?
Wow. Can they win the...
There's so much going on.
Oh, no, wait. They would have to have won the... They're not in the final or anything. They got knocked out, right, of the other one, the Mickey Mouse Cup. So
yeah, the League Cup, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So they're gone now from that. Okay, cool. So it's just four titles and not five. Unlucky Liverpool. Okay, so we've done Arsenal, right? So they're pretty good. Are you going to be investing? Are you thinking really hard about bringing one of them in?
No, because I'm just going to go all in on the blanks, which means that I'm unlikely to bring in players that are going to be blanking in 31. But that strategy probably won't pay off for me.
Fair. I've told but you my strategy, anyway. But I'm doing it anyway, even though I think it's going to be shit. And your viewers should follow. I like that a lot. So you're not planning on bringing it in.
Blanks, doubles. I'm just in.
So you've kept hold of a few players that obviously everyone has kind of tried to get rid of, right? Same. Lundstrom, Mane, Vardy, Madison in there. But Vardy's now come good, and he's the second team we're going to be looking at. Yeah, well, not come good, but his fixtures. Vardy has now come good, as in he's like, if we got points for hitting the post. Corgis love orgies. Wow, that's a... I've pronounced that wrong, but thank you for the follow. What a mental name. Corgis love orgies. Lovely. And TTV Crane Liquor, thanks for the follow as well. Followed before the stream went up 2 hours ago. So thanks, buddy. Crane Liquor is keen. what was I saying? Oh, yeah, Vardy. Vardy is now, fixture-wise, if you look at the next 10 game weeks, is the third best fixtures between now and game week 27, I believe. Yeah, best fixtures in the screen just now. So they got Norwich, Aston Villa, Watford, Brighton. They played really well when Barnes came on against City. Like I said, Vardy hit the post. You've got two of their highest point scorers in your team. You must be like, yes, finally. Now I should be getting points from them, right?
I've got very low expectations, Dave. I mean, admittedly, I have been holding them for this game week 28 Norwich away fixture. But, you know, the reverse fixture was 1-1. So I've not got massive expectations. And I've got a bit of a dilemma because I'm definitely going to be rage transferring those two out if they don't deliver anything for me against Norwich.
Yeah. One game? You're giving them one game?
I've given them like 10 games.
Aye, but that's your fault.
Like, Vardy's been off the boil since Christmas, and Madison's had like a goal since Christmas. I think Barnes is where it's at, and I was a bit surprised to see Barnes not playing against Manchester City.
Well, about that. Why isn't that? Because I want to bring him in, and now I'm like, oh, what's going on? What is going on?
I think Brendan just had an idea, didn't they, of how he wanted to set up against Manchester City.
It almost worked, yeah. I think he sacrificed Barnes for a more defensive-minded player. He played five at the back, didn't he? Because obviously he the problem was like Choudhury was missing, Ndidi was missing, so he had to do something, right?
Because
do you think Barnes in? So this is what I'm planning on doing with the blanks, right? Aguero and Hayden for Barnes and Vardy. Because I think, and now I know you're giving Vardy one more chance, right? But, like, I'm thinking he's going to start banging. They've been quite bullies in terms of, like, always doing well against the smaller teams. And was it you that tweeted out recently the reverse fixtures of these actually are amazing?
It wasn't me, but, yeah, I think I remember seeing that somewhere. I don't think if I was using free transfers, I'd want to be doubled up on the Leicester attack without seeing a bit more from them. All I think you could. I don't know, how many players have you got blanking this week? Could you not just go
four.
Aguero to Vardy?
I could, and leave Hayden in. I've got two free transfers, which might help. And then I would have 3 million to spend. And what my plan was is to make sure that my bench is pretty strong from here on out, so that when I do bench boost, like I don't have to bench boost right away just because I wildcarded recently. I could actually keep my bench fairly decent. For example, Traore has been benched a lot. So therefore, Williams being strong would be good, but the fact that he didn't play meant that, you know, I was actually fucked and I had to get Traore back in. So I want my bench to be a bit stronger than it is. So putting the money from Hayden to Barnes actually makes sense, because Barnes is probably the best sub 6 million player, 6 million and under. He's got the best fixtures coming on. And then I guess I know exactly what you're saying. It's funny to talk about how, like, you being a Vardy owner for ages have a negative biased opinion on him because he hasn't done well for your team, where for me, I took him out in game week 24, so therefore I haven't had that negative connotation for at least, like, I don't know, it was like two fortnights or something, like for a long time, because there was that like massive long winter break that turned into 7 months. So it's been ages since I've owned Vardy and since he's disappointed me, and I just feel like disappointing myself once again, you know what I mean? But the fixtures are great.
You're right, Dave.
Yeah, for both of our sakes, for Norwich, right? But he has the best fixtures, so even if he doesn't do the best, like, it wouldn't be a short-term transfer. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess I can't rage transfer them out for Aston Villa at home either, can I? Because that game, the reverse fixture, they did bang in. Madison looked amazing in that game, and he's not looked that amazing since.
No, that's true. But he did hit the post.
Yeah, he did hit the post.
That we can cling on to the post. The post is where it's at. All right, let's start these, just to jump into a few of them. Would I rather was the theme for the questions today. Every week we do themed questions. This one's would I rather. And oh my God, you guys delivered like ridiculous questions. Let's start with Holly's question. Would you rather have no birthday or no Christmas? Great question.
On trend as well. It's just been your birthday.
My birthday. Christmas was just like last month. Amazing question. A lot of people were like, this caused a lot of controversy. I don't know if you've seen it, right? So Tip said, if I give up Christmas, does Christmas football still happen? Do I still get the day off work? I think it was, who else said something about that? Where are we? I know he's around here somewhere. It was my retweet. I retweeted it and then...
that was it, yeah.
That's the one. Hold on, where are we? I have to find it because it was a really good point. Here we go. Nick said, as a Jew, the answer has to be no Christmas. While the thought of losing American, Canadian, Jewish Xmas tradition of Chinese and movies does sting.
I missed that one.
Exactly. So people who don't celebrate Christmas, right? And then on top of that, Jeff said, if you didn't have a birthday, you wouldn't have been born. So you have to pick no Christmas, which is amazing, right? So we have to talk about it. First of all, does having no birthday mean I wasn't born? Or do you just mean celebration of, would you rather have a no birthday?
Celebration of.
I figured that out,
right?
You've
been born.
Yeah, I've been born.
You can't change that.
So I'm a Mormon then, basically, for just my birthday, I guess.
Yeah.
That's how we would do it. Okay, so what would you do then? No birthday, no Christmas.
No birthday.
Really? You prefer Christmas?
Yeah, you see, you're still young, Dave. Like, every birthday, it's just going downhill all the time. Another year older, further through your life. And like, birthdays are quite like all about you, whereas Christmas, the attention's on everyone.
Right. That's why
I prefer birthday. Like, everyone's celebrating the day together, whereas when it's your birthday, like, people sing to you and, you know.
I don't like that.
You're the only one opening presents.
I do like that part, though. I like that part. No, but I get the whole. You know what? I would actually pick Christmas if it was down to like what we ate, because Christmas dinner's undeniably the best part, and my birthday dinner is usually just like a nice restaurant, where like, so a nice restaurant versus someone cooking for 6 hours, like that is standard. So I prefer Christmas. And your last question, let's just get out of the way, when did you have pancakes today? Was it for breakfast or was it for tea?
Me.
Mm-hmm.
fatigue. Can you not tell that I'm in a little pancake coma still?
Oh no, I can't tell.
I had
but I love
somewhere
that.
between 5 and 10 pancakes. I
Really?
lost count.
I haven't had any
Well,
pancakes
my
today.
husband demanded that we should have 2 batches of pancakes, and then it was too much. But there was like four. There was four left for ages. More pancakes kept coming,
That's
and there was
too
still
many.
four
That's
left.
too many. That's why, like, oh no. Yeah, if you have them for your tea, then you've got enough time to make it like loads. But if you have them for breakfast, you probably only have like, I don't know, you've got time for two, maybe three.
Yeah.
And
Well,
you're
I went
not
on
in there
like
loading up.
Instagram this morning, and everyone's having pancakes for breakfast. I'm like, who has time to make pancakes
That's
for
true.
breakfast
That's
on
true.
a Tuesday and put it on Instagram?
And put it on Instagram. Not only are you cooking, you're cooking and taking fucking pictures.
And then you'd have two and you'd be full.
Yeah, exactly. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. No, I don't really like pancakes that much. That's just me. I would prefer French toast all the way. Ace Ventura says, I own Perez. Risk bringing Barnes in next to him or nah. So instead of Perez, I would prefer Barnes. But if I had Perez, I probably wouldn't side transfer. You in on that as well?
Yeah, completely.
Yeah, awesome. And FPL Bricky says, good evening. And that's it. Thank you very much for coming, Bricky. Me and him
hey,
have got a special bond these days. It's very... Excuse me, very
Can I
lovely.
Ask about this special bond?
Nope.
Was Bricky in London?
Yeah, he was. He was not as drunk as Flapjack, but he was getting there. I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Last team to look at, and it's one that we're going to be talking about forever now, is Wolves. They played amazing, scoring 3 goals against Norwich. Was it just Norwich or was it Jota finally coming good? What are your thoughts?
Jota loves this time of year, doesn't he? And I've only got one Wolves player in my side at the moment. Luckily, I brought one in for 27, but the triple up looks on. I think the big question at the moment is which three to triple up on.
Yes.
Certainly for people like me that are dead-ending into 31, Wolves look the pick of the bunch. And, you know, if you'd have asked me a few weeks ago, I'd have probably said Jimenez, Traore and Boley. And now it's looking like it could be Sice, Jimenez and Jota, or Jimenez, Jota and Patricio.
Yeah, someone not benched all the time.
Well, I think it's 3 clean sheets in 4, isn't it?
Yeah,
I think
they're doing so good.
The thing that we need to consider is the fact that they've shifted formation to a 3-5-2, and it was the 3-4-3 which made Traore a really decent option. And, you know, with Jota and Jimenez performing as well as they are, I can't see Traore getting back in the 2 if they stick with the 3-5-2. And the fact that they've got 3 clean sheets in 4 means that they're probably not going to want to disrupt things too much.
And the fact that they've got a 3-5-2 means that Dockery is a much better option. Obviously, in the first half of the season,
exactly,
they've been playing Dockery behind Traore, and Traore's been doing all the running, doing all the work, doing all the assists. As soon as he doesn't play, Dockery comes in. He's got the assist. So I think that it's really good for Doherty. Also, we've noticed that Saiz, how did you say his name earlier?
Sice.
Sice.
We can just call him Sicey,
like,
though.
No, I like Sice because it's kind of close to Sykes, and I kind of like Oliver and Company. Or Sassy. Yeah, let's just do that. That's fine. That's fair with me. So Sassy is actually maybe a better option, like you said, than Bolly, because he's more attacking prone. He's got a few good passes in him, which is annoying for me, having just brought in Bolly. But I heard that he was going to be rotated with Dendonker, so I don't know what's happening with that.
Yeah.
Did you hear that as well?
I think Bolly's still the safe one. I think there may be a little bit of rotation, especially with the fact that they're pretty much through to the round of 16 in the Europa League as well, aren't they? Which is going to take up another 2 Thursday nights.
I
think as well, though, if they do stick with the 3-5-2, Doherty could be rotated with Traore playing the right wing back.
Oh,
so that
really?
Is something to bear in mind.
That might be good.
That's something that we saw at the start of the season. Not great, though, is it, if you are on Traore or if you're relying on Doherty for something like blank game week 31 and is then rotated.
True.
Although he is amazing.
Well, exactly. So that's hard to get by, is that he actually does really well. In front of me, just as like, because we're on Wolves, this is Magnus Carlsen's team. He got 85 this week. He made 2 transfers for a hit, one of his only hits. His overall rank is 38. Guess who he brought in from this team Who did he bring in for this game week?
Doherty.
Doherty, okay.
And Jota.
It was correct. He brought them in for a hit and got 26 points total. And that's why he is number one at his current profession. That is amazing. So if he's bringing them in, that means that they're options for me. I don't know. He hasn't used his wildcard, I don't think. So that's obviously something to bear in mind. But he's obviously putting emphasis on this blank that's coming up, especially game week 31.
Chips has he used?
Yeah, so how do I check that? Go to game week history and it tells you.
Yeah, game week history. And then
so he used his first wild card and he's used his triple captain, but he hasn't used his second wild card.
Right, okay.
So that's something to bear in mind. But it at least means that...
I reckon he's dead-ending into 31. He seems like a all-in on the blanks and doubles kind of guy, doesn't he?
Yeah. He's got McCarthy only, which is something to know as well. Like, he's just been on that McCarthy train for a while, and he's only just came good... Like, he's had three clean sheets in last. So you can tell he hasn't wildcarded, actually, if we look at it. He's still got Lundstrom, for example. I'm sure that Lundstrom will go now because he's not playing. But he, like you, he kept Manny. So it's really, really interesting that that he's brought him in. So that makes me want to bring Jota in. Do you know what I mean? It's not really points chasing. No one knew he was going to... Well, unless you're Magnus fucking Carlsen, but... No, I certainly didn't think he was going to outscore Jimenez, but he did so well. He's on such form. Five goals in the last two games that he's played.
The thing is, you only need, like, a glimmer of form from him, and then it's go time. He's on form. Get him in.
It's go time. So, yeah, he would definitely be... I could do Barnes and Jota instead of Vardy. Don't know. And then I would have so much money in the bank. I don't even know what I would do with myself. Oh my goodness. How much is Jota's only like? He's like 6.1. Oh my God. I had 4.9 million in the bank. What would I do with that?
Bruno
from instead of Moy. Hold on. I can afford anyone I want. Oh my goodness. Or what about Manny? Bring Manny in instead of Barnes.
After yeah, but you're gonna have to sell Gomez as well, aren't you?
And Gomez, but Ben FPL Shiny has tweeted a thing out today, and I retweeted it, showing that Gomez is actually better points per million than the other two this season, which is mental, isn't it? Considering how many really, really good attacking returns they've had. So I think I'm just gonna keep Gomez until he's dropped that one time I really need him, which is probably this game week. Yeah, sorry, Bruno. So what do you think about him? So let's move on then. These are the kind of, we've just kind of done the blanks, haven't we? So last minute punts for the blanks. You think Bruno's a good shout these days?
I like Bruno. I really want to bring him in. I'm actually considering doing KDB to Bruno this week. Wow. I mean, the fact that he's on penalties is so tempting, isn't it? Because, you know, Manchester United get so many more penalties than any other side. We see it every season. And he's consistent with them.
And you don't think, and obviously Pogba's out and hasn't been anywhere near anything, but that's definitely not a concern in your head. You're not thinking like, oh, Pogba's going to come in as soon as I sign him and Manchester United are going to do that thing they do where they win and then they die. Not even a concern anymore.
Manchester United could do their thing, but I don't think Pogba's an issue. I think Pogba will be off in the summer. Fernandes have just brought in. He's top dog now when it comes to being playmaker in that side.
Yeah. So... Oh, I could get him in for a hit. I could get him in without hitting, and I don't have to bring in Barnes. Oh, Holly, you're ruining my team. You're ruining my plans.
Sorry, Dave.
If we look at Man United, their fixtures are obviously not that great. Let's just look at the blank. Let's just see what they're doing. So Everton away, which we've seen based on the Arsenal game that they can still concede. It's not that big of a deal going away to Everton or at home. You just know that you'll probably concede as well. So it's bad for defensive fixtures, but okay, attacking. And then they've got Man City, which anything can happen. Then they play Tottenham, who have lost all their teeth. So that should be a decent game. And then for the rest of the season, they're banging. So are you thinking, like, I'll bring Bruno in now, and then I can just hold him for the rest of eternity? Is he a long-term punt, is what I'm asking?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay. All right, now I'm going to have to seriously consider this. By the way, while we've been chatting, someone has just came in and said, oh, I thought it was 8 o'clock. And then everyone's been like, yeah, no, it could have been 8 o'clock. Dave is usually late and he's usually pissed. Like, what? I am always at least, at the very most, 5 minutes late.
You're a professional.
I know. I'm on stream. I'm not eating or nothing. No one's mentioned the pizza, by the way. This whole time, I've been paying attention every time I think I just worked late. I worked late, guys. I got a jaw as well. All right. Moving on. Is there any?
That just made no sense.
I worked late, so I couldn't eat before the stream. So I made a pizza, and it was too hot to eat before the stream. And I had to eat a pizza now. Because I can't eat during the podcast that we're recording later on. Are you excited about the podcast? Do you know who we've got? You know who we've got, right?
I know who we've got. I basically recruited who
you
we've
recruited
got.
You recruited who we got. Right, go on then. Yeah. You sell it. You sell it. For all the people who listen and might not listen to the thing. Are we not allowed to say it?
I don't know. You're in charge, Dave. I'm just a guest. You're
don't leave me in charge.
Someone left you in charge.
You know what? James left me in charge, but he absolutely shouldn't have done that. So I'm not going to say anything. But we've got a guest on. I'm going to be hosting the podcast this week, Fantasy Weekly, which means we're a panelist short. So we've got a replacement for me, basically.
Yeah.
And they are a million times better.
What happened was, when Mark left, this person slid into my DMs offering their services for the podcast.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And we'd already got the big din signed up, but I let James know, and James said that whenever anyone's not there, that this guest would be able to step in.
Ah, I like
but
that.
But you'll find out on Wednesday who it is.
Fucking yes. I love that. It was great. Clip that. Put that on the fucking promo. Oh, that was amazing. See, Holly's a professional, and it always makes me smile when anyone comes in here and be professional. It makes me all giddy, like I'm just a school child. No FPL, Jamie. Late at work does not mean being to the pub. I wish it did. I've been at the pub way too much this week. Liam says he was thinking about getting Bruno this week. No, now I want to do it. That team doesn't look too bad, does it? Jota, Barnes, Fernandez in. I don't know who on bench is the problem. I mean, I know this week, right? but because it would be these three. But after that, I have no idea. Shall we do another Would You Rather? Speaking of Liam in the chat, he said, now you don't have to answer this, right? But he said, would you rather give up FPL for life or never have sex again? And then Dave C replied, I'm married. So naturally, FPL is all that I've left, which is hilarious. We're not going to answer that because it's clearly FPL. Let's move on. You want to answer that?
Say, what if my little Bobby wants a brother or sister one day?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Would you rather give up FPL or never have sex again? I'm saying it's clearly FPL you'd give up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Correct. Liam is just Liam. You wouldn't ask that question if you've had sex. I'm kidding, Liam. Okay, Sean asks a very, very good question. Now I'll change it for Jin for you. Okay, so would you rather win FPL for the next 3 seasons or have an unlimited supply of your favorite bourbon/gin? That is the toughest question out of the whole thing.
No,
for
it's
me.
Not. It's not. I don't even know why. Like, when I saw this, I was like, it's obvious. And you could even change it to, would you rather win FPL for 1 season or have an unlimited supply of your favourite gin?
Right,
listen to me, Dave.
That's mental.
No. Okay. Your favourite bourbon, you can buy an unlimited supply of your favourite bourbon. You cannot buy a FPL world champion title.
I wouldn't have
it's
to buy it.
It's what you can't buy.
Yeah, okay, fair enough. That's a good point, actually.
Would you not like to ever win FPL? What are you playing for if it's not to win?
That's true. To have fun, to meet people, to talk to Holly, to have a stream, to make money, all these things. Would you rather win FPL for the next 3 seasons or have an unlimited supply of my favourite bourbon? What if I do... Okay. I could just never... to be honest, I thought it was never drink your favourite bourbon again. It's still
just
really
think
hard.
About how much money you could earn if you was an FPL world champion. You could buy
all
the bourbon in the world.
You could get into anything, right? Yeah, no, fair enough. FPL Actuary said, would you rather give up FPL or give up your wife/girlfriend? And Sean said, that's a tough one. It's not like I can just give up my right hand. Hey! So let's answer this.
I love that handle, FPL Actuary.
It's like decent,
it's
wasn't it?
It's one step up from FPL Accountant.
Oh, don't tell that. I've had the accountants on here. shout out to FPL Audit. Oh, are you? Unlucky. That sucks. How is work? I don't really want to know. My mate's an accountant, like he's done his whole thing, he's a chartered accountant. Sometimes I accidentally ask him what he's been up to, and it's such a mistake. What was I going to say? Oh yeah, so would you rather give up FPL or give up your significant other? Now, the answer is really obvious, because I would absolutely give up FPL over my significant other. But okay. how are you feeling about that? Are you the same? You guys pretty good? Because I think you would never answer this like, oh, I would never give up FPL, unless you guys weren't like, you weren't doing too well, which would be amazing to have
a responsible parent now, haven't I?
It'd be great if I brought you on.
He's part of that as the father of the baby.
That's true. He is the second half of the team.
Exactly. You'll have to give up FPL. So be a single parent, and I don't think I could cope with being a single parent.
And is it not his mum that helps out, right? Like he's like it's always the stepmom. Exactly. I hear. Yeah. So there you're losing yeah. his family, which I get it. Wait. For me, this is funny. It would be hilarious if I brought you on and you were like, oh, I'd give up FPL, or I would give up my husband in a heartbeat. And then that a chain of reaction, and then like three pods down the line, I'm sorry, I can't come, I'm visiting my lawyer, and then like and it moves on.
I
from
can't
there
come because I've got nobody to look after the child.
Yeah, exactly. And you change your name to FPL divorce, and all right, that'd be funny. These are good, so thank you very much for sending all this stuff. So here's one that I see often, but it's a really good one. So would you rather finish top for one season and never play again, or always finish in the top 100k?
Top for one season, because you could just retire after that, couldn't you?
You would just retire. You'd be like, might
if
drop.
It was top 10k or top 5k, then I might be a bit more interested. But top right. 100k, nah, I'm not bothered.
But you could.
I want to win.
For me though, like, how would that work? My brain, as you guys know, like, I'm autistic, so like I have to think of things in like ones and zeros. It's really difficult for me to get emotional about it. So in terms of like going on, would you rather finish top for one season? Okay, that's my number one. So the highest I could get is what, first place, right? But then after that, if every season I could only ever finish top 100k, that means that the place 100,000 is now my number one. So if I hit top 100k again, I've just won, right? The best I could do is top 100k. So that answer is the exact same. Would you rather finish top for one season and never play again, or always finish top 100k? They're the same thing for me, right? It just means the second one, always finish in top 100k, I could keep playing as long as I wanted to. So that question doesn't make sense, but it's really interesting to hear other people's opinions of it. Did that make sense for anyone else? Was I just talking shite for like, I see your face, you're just like, I want to understand. if there is a ceiling and someone puts an arbitrary ceiling up, then it's still a ceiling, it doesn't matter. Oh well, fuck it, we'll move on. Fella, it was a philosophical one for me. And Holly just said, okay, so here's the one, we'll stop.
Fancy
we'll...
minute pancakes.
Yeah. The sugar coma. I mean, what can I do? Colin, who is the accountant I was talking about? He's my mate, Colin Mick, 1888, big Celtic fan.
You see, I could not see the question here because he had a little lock on his account.
Ah, okay, you can't see the question if you've got a lock. You have to be followed, he has to follow you. Interesting. I was wondering why I only got one like, because I thought it was a really good question. Okay, I'll read it out for you. You've committed a very minor crime, but the state has decided your punishment is to have a footballer strike your shin full force wearing Puma Kings. Would you rather it was Prime John Anarisa or Prime Roberto Carlos? And that's the shoe-in question. So these guys, as we are well aware, hit things extremely hard with their feet. So who would you rather take a bit of a run up and smash your shins with these? Because, I mean, the shin's gone, right? The question, what are you answer? I'm going to eat some pizza.
I don't know. John Anarisa.
All right, I wonder what the chat is. Chat, would you rather? I think I would want Risa just because I'm like, I think he'd be nicer about it afterwards.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, he'd probably pay for like a nice pillow in the hospital or something.
He seems a little bit less intimidating.
Yeah, let's look at them. That's actually a good point. So let's hold on, copy and paste his last name, because their face does matter for me. Like, who am I looking at while my shin's getting kicked in? That matters.
It's just one to consider all the time, isn't it?
It is.
That's
I think about
why
this
I'm
constant.
Such a fan of James Milner.
You love the Liverpool lad. All right, so him, nice and... I'm going to go into the... There's him pulling his wee bit of his top out. Oh, he loves to get his top off, doesn't he? Oh, he's got a wee baby with his kit. Oh, that's cute. Right, okay, so him, nice baby, cute, everything... or Roberto Carlos. That I'm gonna use this picture. There
oh,
we go.
gosh.
Right? Like that is what he just looks like he wants to hit me. That's what no, it's definitely Risa. I think you're right.
It's an easy decision in the end on that.
Yeah. You're right, Colin, what a shit question. Okay. Let's go back to FPL. So the last thing that I wanted to talk about, because we are 20 hours, 17 minutes in, we got 13 minutes left, is what are your plans going forward? Not just captaincy-wise, but like, what are you thinking for transfers this week? If you're on the run-up to Blank Game Week 31, what are you thinking? And I've got your team in front of me.
So I'm thinking this week that I'm going to go De Bruyne to Fernandes.
Right, okay. So that's why you asked FPL General, is it time to get rid of De Bruyne?
Yeah. And now I feel like I'm going to have to listen to his podcast to see if he answered my question.
You're going to have to listen to him. Shots fired.
And then I'm going to upgrade Stecklenburg.
Uh-huh.
To either Pope or Patricio, and I think I'm going to go Pope because even though I'm doubled up on the Burnley defence, I don't want to commit to doubling up on the Wolves defence with Sice and Patricio,
right?
Because I could potentially want Jimenez or Jota or Traore.
Yeah, there's more assets that you want in Wolves.
Yeah,
so you don't want to spend a player.
So that's the plan for 28, but I'm not going to make those transfers until late on Friday because there's this rumoured double game week 29, which is pure speculation at the moment. But I wouldn't want to sell KDB if he did have a double next game week.
Yeah, that's the thing. So you've got a little bit of time now because you're not doing it this game week, right? Or sorry.
Yeah.
You're not going to be doing it till later this game week. We'll have all the stuff figured out by then, hopefully.
Yeah, exactly. So if the other thing I could do is just do Henderson to Pope. That's my other thing, because I think I've only got two players that blank plus Henderson. So I can bench Lundstrom and De Bruyne if I need to, and just do Henderson to Pope and roll a free transfer if I need to.
Okay.
So then we've got 3 weeks to 31, haven't we?
Yep. And for people who in the chat, because Daff's asked, and then people have already tried to explain it to him in the chat in previous streams, in like two sentences, what is Game Week 31 blank? Why is that happening?
Right, it's going to be carnage because it's FA Cup quarterfinals, I think. Uh-huh. And there's at least two FPL three FPL fixtures on, but it's unlikely to be more than four or five fixtures. So I'm basically building a team of players that have got a game in 31 and then I'm going to wildcard afterwards. So the confirmed fixtures are involving Wolves, Burnley, Watford and Bournemouth at the moment.
Cool.
And then it looks like Norwich and Everton could go into that game week as well. And then we could potentially have Liverpool, Palace as well.
Okay.
So at the moment then, I'm working on there only being three fixtures.
Oh, really? What ones are you thinking are definitely going to happen? Liverpool, I guess, hopefully.
No, not Liverpool. The two green ones and then Norwich Everton.
Right, okay. Because you don't think Norwich are going to beat Tottenham?
No.
Are you going to bring in Pukki? Could he make an appearance?
No. So I've got Pope, Taylor.
Yep.
Maybe Rico.
Maybe Rico. Sice.
So I can probably cobble together three defenders there.
Yep.
And then I've got Cantwell.
Yep.
Calvert-Lewin. So I've got six players at the moment and I've still got three transfers. So I can have nine players in a rubbish blank game week 31, using free transfers. And that'll do me. If Liverpool comes in, great. But if they're not in, doesn't really bother me. Because if Liverpool aren't in, then there's really not anyone to choose from.
Yeah,
so I'll be looking at getting in a couple more Wolves players with two of my transfers. And then, you know, might punt on Richarlison as well.
Fair enough. For Daft, who's asking, who are Norwich playing? They're playing Everton at home. So it's not the worst fixture. It's not the best. It's definitely not a two, which is what this is saying, because Everton are kind of on the upswing. But yeah, it's not like they're playing, you know, Liverpool or anything like that. It should be okay. That's a good plan. Everyone keeps talking, because Pope was the big transfer out, wasn't it? And then now everyone's kind of bringing him back in. I know Flapjack did it.
Yeah.
You're planning on doing it. I've got MacArthur, I think. So I don't think I need to do anything, but I could still save some cash if I did leave Henderson. And he's not got that great fixtures. But the thing was, if you're like me and you got this double up, which quite a few people have, it would be McCarthy next game week, because obviously thingy's blanking. And then you would also play him against Newcastle and Norwich game week 29, game week 30, because Henderson is playing, unless you wanted to play him against Norwich at home, Henderson. But Newcastle wave, it's a not as good of a fixture. The game week 31, game week 32 is the problem, because it doesn't matter if Henderson is blanking or not, he can't play against Man United. And then on top of that, Tottenham's like a hard fixture, no matter if they've got, you know, Son or not. So in terms of McCarthy, the only problem would be game week 31, which is exactly kind of why I've got him in, because he's playing Arsenal. So even though he would be my goalkeeper, he's got a shit fixture. So it might make me want to change him, unless I'm using a free hit, in which case I don't really have to deal with it. So that's the thing I need to figure out. For me, if Liverpool are playing in game week 31, then I am not going to free hit. And if they, because then that's, I've pretty much got, you know, 7 or 8 players already there. But if they aren't playing, I'm going to have to free hit.
What, for who? Pookie?
I know, exactly. But it's better than that than play 5 players.
Yeah, but show, is that your team on the screen now?
Yeah, so this is what I've got working with. This is what I've got working with.
So
say they don't play. So that's 1, 2, 3. Henderson's not playing. Manchester United's not playing. Southampton's not playing.
I'm seeing this in delay, so.
Barnes won't be playing. Because you're just assuming that it's the 5 teams, right? So there. So that's all I've got.
Yeah.
That's right. What I've got.
You've got 3 Wolves players and that's it.
Yeah. So I think free hit's probably a good idea, because even if I free hit and it doesn't do like amazing, it's going to be better than if I try and bring in transfer. That means that I can't punt on people like Fernandes yet or bring Barnes in properly. I would need to make that decision right now. But if I play, if I have Salah and I have Gomez and I have Alexander-Arnold, then I would only need to make maybe 3 transfers between Game Week 29 and Game Week 31, and I could have at least 9 players and I'd be okay with that. Because I only really had 10 players
to begin
with.
Who are you going
to
have? Like, some Burnley defenders, Pookie, Richarlison, Calvert-Lewin.
Might double up on the old Pookie Cantwell, yeah.
Still sounds grim, doesn't it?
It is grim. It's very grim. What, so you think I should just have these 6 and that's it? And don't worry about it?
I think, well, I don't know. It's hard, isn't it?
It is really hard. And especially
it's
on
just
like
such
live.
A boring free hit, isn't it?
I know. But it's just not having a wild card. If I start bringing all these players in... So my options are... I'm not bringing shit players in. That's just, I can't, because I'd have to transfer them out again. So the only options I've got is A, free hit, easy peasy, bring shit players in for 1 week and then get my team back. Or B, don't free hit, but also don't bring shit players in and have like max seven, eight players for the blank. And then if Liverpool don't play, I would only have 5. So that's the options, 5 players or a free hit.
Yeah, I think I need to hope that Liverpool don't go through, because then there's going to be people playing free hits that are dull, and it should give me an advantage later in the season when I do free hit.
Mm-hmm. But I'm working towards having a good bench boost for the double as opposed to the free hit.
Yeah.
Which is why I can do that thing where I'm like, I'm bringing in Barnes and Fernandes and Jota now, because I can spread the funds throughout the rest of the season. But it's a fun thought experiment. I don't really mind what I do, because this season is just like a fun, like, I'm just going all out attack now because of how bad I was doing. So it's fun to this isn't stressful for me, but I know there's people out there that is really stressful. And we've got 3 minutes left, Holly, so I wanna just give them a little message of encouragement if they are being stressed and they're not like me and they can just take it on the chin because he's a cool guy and he's handsome and his birthday was yesterday.
Well, it's just a game, isn't it? It's meant to be fun. But that's what we're here for, to have fun. And especially being on your streams, Dave, they're all about fun. And mm-hmm. I've been on the sidelines. I finally made it in.
Yeah, starting
made
team.
Made it in life. Twitch duo for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Just got to enjoy the game. Enjoy watching the football.
Yeah.
That's what I'd say.
Enjoy watching the football. That's actually a great point. Don't get all hung up because you don't have Son and he scored 2 goals, because he'll probably get injured the next game week. Like, don't worry about it. Thank you so much for coming on. It was really enjoyable. Should we do one last? I think we've got one last thing. Would you rather go without Liverpool or Man City assets for the rest of the season?
Man City. Easy.
Easy peasy. Okay, that was a rubbish one to end on. I was going to end on that one. I decided not to do it. I don't think you can answer that. Battle of the memberships. Would you rather pay for FF Scout membership or FF HQ? I would get both. I would get both. That's an easy answer.
Yeah, I've got both.
Well, thank you very much for coming on. I really appreciate it. Thanks, everyone, for joining us in the chat. Like I said, if you're new here, follow. We're going to get someone awesome. Maybe even Holly and someone else. We'll bring you on for like a super special. The gang back. Oh, that'll be fun. You get Mark in. We'll have a chat. That'll be good. But yeah, thank you
See
very
how
much.
He's doing.
Exactly, just, you know, give him a cuddle. He's probably missing us. He probably is. I will see you guys on Thursday for Thursday stream, and I will see you guys on Wednesday if you listen to the podcast. And that's it from me. No, I'm kidding. Thanks very much, guys. I'll see you later. Bye. I think we'll get that reference at the end there.
No. Maybe.
That's hopefully.
I liked it though.